we're here today for our son Thomas, who cannot speak for himself and will never speak again. Although we are here to represent him, we have had no rights or say at all in the procedures that have brought us here or in the decision that has been made here today. It has been reported in the media many times that on July 9th, 2012, my husband Ralph and I made the decision to turn off Thomas's life support. We did not make that decision. That decision was made for us on July the 7th at 10:07 p.m. when our beautiful defenseless son Thomas was king hit with such force and violent intent that when his head hit the pavement, the very essence of what made him Thomas was gone there and then. There was no coming back from that. Thomas was on the brink of manhood with a life of promise ahead to add positively to the society he inhabited. He was a young man who loved his family and friends and epitomized respect. Decent citizens show respect because they live with those very core moral values instilled and nurtured within them. Those who lack that respect, who have no core ethics for either themselves, their neighbours, or society at large, never think beyond themselves. They act with total disregard for the consequences of their actions. It is for this reason that we as a society depend on our courts to protect us by ensuring that the consequences for actions so heinous as to result in the loss of another human life must reflect the impact of the crime. They must be prepared to accept responsibility for their decisions, and until this happens, nothing will ever change. It is up to us as a society to stand together and refuse to accept these unconscionable acts of violence be allowed to continue. It is equally repugnant that these perpetrators of violent crime be permitted the opportunity to remorselessly re-offend over and over again. Our family has lost a son, brother, grandson, nephew, and cousin. We will never forget our darling Thomas. We will never stop missing him, and our lives will never be the same. What has the perpetrator lost? It's time we all come to the same realization just who the victim is in violent crimes, and it's not the offenders. So let's stop treating them as the victims. Thank you.